meet me on your seats, whatever that looks like for you. Perhaps cross-legged. If you want to do hero pose, you can. But if you feel safe to do so, go ahead and close the eyes. And you can rest the palms on the knees, or you can cup your hands in your lap, but find this nice long spine, but keeping the bottom of the chin parallel to the floor. So oftentimes people like to look up. Let's keep that nice neutral neck where the ears are above the shoulders. And then just take a few breaths here. Eyes are closed. We're tuning out to tune in. Be selfish with these 45 minutes. Selfish as in don't let anything else take up your energy. How can you stay present in this practice? Feeling the tailbone root into the floor or the carpet. And energetically lifting up from the crown of the head. We want to think lifting up through the front body and rooting down in the back body. So there's this nice energetic balance here. And start to slow down the inhale and the exhale. Even letting the legs relax. Oftentimes we hold our legs up. Noticing any sensations in the body. Perhaps the shoulders kind of need to release a bit more. A softening in the jaw. An expansion in the belly. Love the beginning of a new month, an opportunity to begin again, to start over. Not that we need to wait until the beginning of a month, but it just feels good, you know, fresh month on the calendar, a clean slate, maybe. Can we approach our practice on and off the mat with this clean slate mentality, the ability to start fresh, the ability to not hold on to the past and not reach for the future, but be right here, right now. Let go of any expectation of this practice of how your body needs to be or do or feel, and move with ease and awareness. Taking care of the body when it tells you to rest and when it tells you to move. Take a deep breath in. Let it go. Big ones. Inhale again. Exhale. And again, inhale. Fill it up. Exhale slowly. You can keep the eyes closed here. Nothing fancy. I'm just taking a neck roll, one ear to one shoulder, drawing the chin to the chest and rocking to the other side. So I skip going to the back. I just rock side to center to side, allowing the shoulders to just shimmy down.
good.
And then find your neutral neck. You can still keep the eyes closed, look to the right, feel the stretch along the right side of the neck, or sorry, opposite side. And then look to the left. And then back to center. Ooh, slowly open the eyes if they're not already. Perhaps smile at each other even though we're on Zoom. Let's take these arms up, inhale, reach. Shoulders still down, exhale, press away. So resistance, right? As if we were underwater. Inhale, pushing through, feeling the weight, right? And then exhale, let it go. Let's take one more, inhale, reach. Exhale, press the fingertips together and draw the elbows out to the sides. Shoulders down. I always feel like I'm about to do a little dance here, but I like the energy of the fingertips pressing into each other. We're building up awareness of the back, of the shoulders and the forearms. On your next inhale, lift up your legs and uncross the legs so that the other one is here, right there. Shimmy, shimmy, side to side. And then release, roll the wrist out. And let's take a nice side bend. Doesn't matter which way, just keep the hip bones into the earth and open up. All right, so not forcing this elbow to come down. Maybe you just stay on your hand and keep that shoulder pulling back away from you. So we're not shading the face. Inhale, lift up, exhale, ooh, other side. Anchoring the hip bones down. And so there's this energy reaching the fingertips, never just a boop, it's always continuing. Inhale again, exhale, release. You can go a bit deeper, maybe the elbow comes down. You notice what you feel in the shoulder blade. And one last time here. Gentle, nice flow, good. And then from here, can you continue that towards the front, peel forward? Ooh, hey, walk the fingertips forward, allow the neck to be loose here. And shake side to side. So you're in a little bit of a forward fold. Deep breath in and deep breath out. We're gonna start to pick up the pace a little bit. Yeah. Good. And then slowly walk it up. And shoulders up, back and down. Good. And then from here, let's go ahead and rock forward to our first table. So hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Have a little of a party. So spread the fingers wide, knees right underneath those hips, nice long spine. You know how we do, take the belly down, inhale, curl up, look up to the sky. Exhale, press away from the mat, cat. Good, two more, inhale, lift. Lift it up, exhale, carve it out. And again, inhale, cow. Exhale, draw the navel in. Good, and then just like a kitty cat, take any other variation here so you can wag the tail, look over. You can undulate through the body, reverse. Head to tailbone connection. Do what feels good. Good, and then from here, take your knees wide, toes to touch. Push the hips back, and let's say hello to the back body. Resting the forehead down, reaching the fingertips forward. So sink those hips back. Deep breath in, deep breath out. So try to relax the feet into the mat. It's like hella energy. I love it. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Good, and then inhale, lift the head up, clawing your hands into the floor. See if you can push through and drop your hips down into an upward facing dog. So notice my shoulders aren't near my ears. I press away and lift up through the front body. Then tuck the toes. Let's go straight into our first downward dog. Nice. So walk the dog nice and slow, hips high to the sky, lengthen through the back. Exactly. So there's always options here for your down dog. You can always bend the knees and then shift the hips up high. The heels don't have to come down, right? That comes with time and practice. But I just want you to feel your dog here. How can you let your shoulders drive down the back? How can you reach your hips high to the sky? And so just to show you, there are variations to downward facing dog. So I'm going to show you that with two blocks, right? If you have them, feel free to grab them if you don't. But let's say my shoulders are hella tight. I can put blocks underneath here and it allows me to go a bit deeper, right? Because I'm elevated. You can also take it under your feet if you feel a little short in the back part of your body, and I can get this nice deep stretch here. Whew. Yogi's choice. Shake the head left and right. And then let's flow back into our plank. Just roll back to plank. Aligning shoulders over wrists. Pressing away from the floor. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Build some strength. Press away, press away. Exhale, downward facing dog. Hips high to the sky. Walk your dog. Good. Inhale, lift your right leg up high, as far as you can go. And then bring that foot in between the hands. So pull that right hip crease back. Drop the left knee. And take a nice low lunge. Inhale, reach the arms up. Scoop up in the front belly, shoulders down the back. We don't want to break the rib cage. Now we can lift up through the chest for a nice back bend. Find that balance. Exhale, reach. And then hands to the floor. Or a block, or your fingertips. From here, we're going to go straight into a half split. I extend the front leg, I push the hips back. Toesies towards the shin, lift up through the front body. Now those shoulders always want to creep up. You got to keep telling them to go down, down, down. Breathe. The more you flex that foot, deeper the stretch in that calf. Good, come back to your low lunge. Hey, let's hang here. Bring your hands on the inside of that foot. Right, so typically it's on the other side. I want both of them on the inside of that front foot. And then let's heel toe this front heel off the mat into lizard. So it looks like this. I was here, boop, and then now I'm here. Okay, yogi's choice to stay here on the hands or to come down to a lower expression. We're going straight into these hips today. Allow the head to fall. Feel free to take a block to the forehead. And let's hang there for a second. Call this lizard pose. Yep. Breathe. Yep. And if you're on your hands too, all good. You just want to keep that knee in alignment over the heel, right? So oftentimes people go like this. You want to make sure that it's underneath the knee. Good. If you're here, see if you can take a nice twist. Breathe. Kind to the body. Got this, come back. Nice, my friends. Good, from here, rock your hips back. Swing that leg back around. And then let's take a quick child's pose. Hiya, reset the body. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Allow the head to relax. Press your palms into the floor. Look up, and then shift into your plank. Nice and strong. Then exhale. Right from there, reach the hips up, downward facing dog. Walk your dog. Okay? So I don't care about a perfect triangle, but what we do want is a lengthened spine. So that might mean you bend your knees here to find that. Inhale, lift the left leg up. Three-legged dog. Exhale, bring the left foot in between the hands. Hi-ya! Yep. If you need blocks, this is where you would use them. Choo-choo. Pull that left hip crease back. Ha, ga, 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 and then drop the back knee. Inhale, rise up, low crescent lunge, taking it slow. Shoulders down. Space between the ears and the arms. Pull up in the lower belly. Exhale, take the elbows down, lift up through the chest. Open up that heart, Care Bear moment. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bring the hands or the fingertips to the earth. Scoop, push the hips back, nice half splits. Toes towards the shin, lengthen through the back. Woo! So if you want to feel this more, drop that hip a little bit lower as you keep the toesies towards the shin. Lengthen through the back of the neck, breathe. Stay with me, good. Exhale, come back to the low lunge. Doot, 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 doot. Then get those hands on the inside. Ba-da. All right, and then heel toe off your mat to a lizard. So knee directly above the ankle bone. Wherever the toes are, the knees are. Lift up. Yogi's choice to go deeper, up to you. For the lowest expression you have, no right or wrong way, just the safe way. Breathe. Allow the head to relax if you can, if you're down here. Good, and then inhale, lift up wherever you are and take the left hand up for a nice twist. Woo! Nice, y'all. Up, up, up. Literally the movie with the balloons, and then bring the hand back down to the earth. All right, shift your hips, then swing that leg around, and then knees together, toes together. Hiya, push back, child's pose. This time, take your arms behind you. Let's give our shoulders a little break so you can rest them on the mat. Sometimes I like to cross behind my back. It helps me put more weight, right? That's the one thing I miss about in-person classes is I can't, put my hands on you in a loving way. But here you can kind of add some weight to the lower back. See how that feels. My glasses are fogging up. I don't know about you. Can't wait to get some new contacts. Okay, slowly release your fingers. Drag them along the mat. And then reach the arms past your head. Inhale, lift the head up. Okay, so make sure your hands are in the same line right here. Go as far as you can. And then you're gonna claw. You're gonna go straight into upward facing dog. Oh, drop the hips. Lift up through the chest, shoulders down. And then scoochie the hips back. Woo, 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 like this. Tuck your toes. And then downward facing dog. Walk your dog. Breath in, deep breath out. Inhale, lift your right leg up. Keep your hips and shoulders squared off to the mat. Exhale, bring the right foot through. Yogi's choice to drop the back knee, or you can stay on the fingertips, but you kind of want to have like this running stance. I don't know, I don't run, so I don't know what those look like, but it feels like a running stance. Pull this hip crease back. And then let's take that twist we did earlier. I'm going to lift my right arm up. If you need a block, you could place it underneath your left hand. Good, exhale. Inhale, rise up to high, woohoo, high crescent lunge. So legs are feeling this heat. I'm deep in this lunge, yogi's choice if you wanna drop the back knee. Breathe, lift up low. Balance is all over today, that's okay. Inhale, reach the arms up. Woo. Nice, strong, high lunge. And exhale, lean forward, hands together, and then we're gonna take an airplane. Reach the arms back. Inhale, reach back up. Twist up hamstrings, good. And then exhale, airplane, drop back. Beautiful, one more. Feel that heat, feel the shake. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bring it back. Then hands to the earth. Pull. And then you're gonna take a nice side plank. Okay, we're building heat for real. You're gonna take your knife edge of the left foot, and then you're gonna take a variation of a side plank. You can always drop the knee if you have bad shoulders or you're just not feeling it today. Bring your fingertips up, lift the hips up high, and then come back to plank. Then exhale, downward facing dog. Yes, y'all. Let's go the other side. Feel free to take a breather if you need. Inhale, lift the left leg up. Hips and shoulders squared off to the mat. Exhale, bring the left foot through. Lift up. Scoop up in the belly and reach up to high crescent lunge. So in your lunge, don't want to be here. Maybe you drop the back knee a little bit and find that alignment and then straighten. Breathe. Then exhale, lean forward. Let's take airplane. You lean the body forward, reach the fingertips back. Like you're about to run. Two more times, inhale, reach up high. Lunge, feel the strength of the legs. Exhale, shaky, shaky, eggs and bakey. One more, inhale, reach. Beautiful, exhale. Y'all look good. I see you, I see you, I see you. Hoya, inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands to the floor. Take a nice twist, left arm up to the sky. And then bring it back. Then yogi's choice for how we do this side plank. I'm gonna roll to the right edge of my foot. And I'm gonna take it here. Make sure the arms are stacked. Variation is dropping the bottom knee. You know your body, you do you. When my shoulders are in pain, I don't do the full side plank. Come back to your plank. Hi-ya! Exhale, downward facing dog. Take out the head. Ooh, drop the knees to the earth. Take your knees wide. Push the hips back. Let's take a chill pill for a second. Ooh, rest. Release the wrist. Feel free to take a roll here. Knees wide, toes touch, hips back. Notice what you feel. Inhale, lift your head up. And then come back to a regular table. Let's reset that body with a cow cat. Drop the belly, inhale cow. Exhale, cat. And then meet me in your plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then look to the top of your mat. Step or hop your feet to meet your hands. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. So hands on the shins or the thighs. Maybe soften the knees to protect it. Nice long neck. Exhale, release. Inhale, roll up, stacking the vertebrae. Woo! Yither, standing up. Take it out. How y'all doing? Thumbs up? Give me a thumb. Yes, amazing. My glasses are like so foggy. Fun stuff. I love this song. I'm actually playing the journaling playlist right now. Y'all can still hear music? Yeah. Yes. You know. Little two step. Little two step. Let me stop. This is what a late bedtime does to me. All right. Stand. Like a human being, feet apart. Reach one fingertip down. Let's take a nice stretch of the neck here. Switch. bend the knees here, shake it out. Yeah, exactly. Nice. And then do a little ditty here. Let the arms hit your back, your booty. Good. And then just take a nice big shoulder roll. Did a lot in the shoulders. Maybe a nice arm circle.
Not that guy singing.
Side.
Yeah, he drinks and he sings. And
shift your weight to one leg. Let's roll the ankle. Maybe you play with the leg. Good, shift your weight. Just get your own movement into the body. Doesn't matter how it looks, doesn't have to be pretty. Maybe you aim for ugly. That works, still beautiful, right? And good, meet me in this nice wide stance. From here, you are going to turn your heels in. All right, so we went from parallel to in. So nice tall spine. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, we're gonna take goddess pose. Yeah, so drop the tailbone down. Sometimes I feel like hella sumo. It's all in perspective. Yeah, so elbows down, knees pushing back, right? Tailbone heavy, so not here, but underneath yourself. Everything is stacked. Nice and radiant, perfect song. Inhale, reach. Stretch beyond you, exhale. Two more, inhale, reach. Exhale, you got this, one more. Inhale, reach. Exhale. Stay here, hang here. Maybe you bring the hands on the hips. Get a little bit of leg work. Feel free to pop one heel up and pulse just a little bit. Breathe. Maybe both heels up and down and up and down. Use your breath. Drop your seat. If you like this type of stuff, try the bar class. Heels up. Nice rounded arms here. Balance here or fall. Doesn't matter. And exhale. Whew, release. Heel toe your feet together. Shaky, shaky, little like run in place. Tap it out, beautiful. All right, meet me at the top of your mat. Walk to the top of your mat. Taking our first sun salutation. Inhale, reach up to the sky. Up, 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 gather the stars. Exhale, spread the stars. I like that. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Hands on the shins or the thighs. Hands to the earth. Step your right foot back. Step your left foot back. Yogi's choice, right? For a vinyasa, I'm gonna do variation. Drop the knees, draw the elbows in. Drop the chest. Inhale, lift cobra or up dog. Roll through the feet, downward facing dog. Walk the dog. Hips high, nice y'all. Your dog is gonna look different from my dog and from her dog, yeah. Good, Kaya, nice. See what happens if you walk your feet in a little bit closer to your hands and then bend your knees and then lift your hips up high like you're scooping, yes. There you go, and then anchor the heels down. Breathe, inhale, lift right leg up, here we go. Exhale, right foot in between. Right away, rise up. Continue the rotation to warrior two. So warrior two, your hips are facing me, maybe, or the screen. This back foot is parallel. Knees here, extend those arms. One long line here. Sometimes it's cool to put it in gallery mode so you can see your body or pin yourself if you want to watch yourself. I don't think we talk about that enough on virtual classes. Like, hey, it's okay to come up to the screen, look at what other people are doing, and come back. Right? That's the beauty of moving together, is you have other people to look at. Reach forward. Let's take a nice reverse warrior.
anchor the shoulder down, keep the knee in line with those toes. Exhale, take that forearm down, nice side angle. Keep a nice long legs, peel the shoulder back, peel the ribs back. Exhale back to warrior two. All right, we're gonna do a fun little thing. We're gonna straighten that front leg. So both legs are straight. We're gonna take Trikonasana. So both legs straight, back foot is parallel. These toesies are to the front. I reach for something on the table across the room until I can't go anymore, and then let the arm take you down and whoop, lift up towards the sky. So you would imagine me coming behind you, peeling your rib cage back. Legs are feeling it. Side body's feeling it. And then exhale. Back to warrior two. Cartwheel the hands back down. Step back to your plank. Yogi's choice for vinyasa. I'm gonna skip it and go straight to downward facing dog. Look to the top of your mat. Bend your knees. Step or hop your feet to meet your hands. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Breathe, exhale, release. Feel the heat. Inhale, root to rise. Hey. Exhale, hands together. Shake it out. All right, cool. So we're gonna do that on the other side. Y'all good? Yeah? Yeah, and that downward dog looked good, right? So it's just a few things the body needs to, you know, adjust. Let's do that on the other side and then we'll start to cool down. It's like the ultimate journaling song. All right. Yo, I'm dripping. Let's do this. Inhale, reach up. Gather your stars. Exhale, sprinkle the stars all the way down. Inhale, lengthen. You go at a pace that feels good for you. You don't have to go at my pace. Hands to the floor. Step or hop your feet back to a plank. Yogi's choice to rock forward and do Chaturanga Dandasana. If you don't know how to do that, skip it and go straight to downward facing dog. I got you. Definitely do a fundamentals class coming soon. Inhale, lift your left leg up nice and high. Exhale, bring the left foot through. Right away, my friends, cartwheel up to warrior two. So warrior two is your knee over the heel. Can you turn your hips to the side a little bit more? Press into the back edge of that back foot. Breathe here, look over the fingertips. Nice, strong warrior two. Inhale, reach forward, take reverse warrior, reach back. Full commitment to the practice, right? You guys are doing awesome. Come back up, turn the palm up, forearm down on the thigh, reach the other arm up. Remember what I said, peeling the ribs back, the body back. Same feeling when you are in a triangle pose. Exhale, come back to warrior two. Straighten your front leg. So now both legs are straight. My hips naturally want to turn this way. I'm gonna do my best to turn towards you, right? It just means I don't have as much rotation on this leg. Now, reach for something on the hot stove. Reach for it, not the hot stove, the counter. Take it down and meet me here. What do you feel? The legs? Can you lift up a little higher maybe? Can you rotate a little bit further back? Soften in the jaw. And then lift back up. Warrior two, beautiful cartwheel. Back down, step back to your plank. Yogi's choice for the last vinyasa. Inhale, lift cobra or up dog. You can always drop the knees here, y'all. Like it doesn't have to be a full flow. Exhale, or not a full flow, but you know what I mean. Do a variation if the body wants that. Hips high to the sky. Exhale, drop the knees. Knees together. push the hips back. Child's pose, release the arms behind you. Job well done. Breathe. Definitely energizing flow for this Saturday. Felt some work, felt some space, some sweat maybe. Drag the fingertips towards your face. Press yourself up into hero pose.
Sit up here, align the shoulders back, pull up in the lower belly. Close the eyes, take a moment to recalibrate. Feel any breeze in the room or lack of breeze. Come back to the body and the breath. Feeling vitality. The life force in our yoga practice. Accessible off the mat as well. A few more breaths here as we start to cool down in our practice. Going up in the lower belly, closing the ribs, just to find that nice tall alignment. Favoring the practice, favoring how you feel, taking a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Feeling good, feeling great. Feeling great, feeling good. Awesome. All right, sweet friends. Feel free to open up the eyes. Bring the hands behind you, clasp the fingers, and pull the fingers down for a nice chest opener, shoulders down. And then slowly release. Swing your legs from underneath you. And then take the legs in front of you. All right, so if you have a bolster, a block, or a pillow, I know I didn't cue you beforehand, but feel free to stack those on top of you as you reach forward. Or if you don't want that, just reach forward. Allow the head, whew, I feel my hamstrings, my calves. Find what feels good here. Allowing the shoulders to melt, just a release of the lower back and a stretch of the legs. And inhale, slowly roll it up. You need to scoot down a little bit because we're gonna lay down in our back here. But let's sit up nice and tall. Draw the feet to the earth. Lean back, nice long spine. Meet me in a boat. And just float here. Feel free to do creative movement here. Like you're floating in the sky, or feel free to find stillness. And feel free to lift up one hip at a time just to get a little bit of lower belly work. And also a nice booty massage too. If you like these added elements, definitely try the bar class. And then slowly release your feet to the floor and fold over. Allow your head to hang. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. And then hands underneath the thighs, draw the navel in. Roll down. Oh yeah, all the way to the earth. Nice, let's press your feet into the floor, hips in line with the heels, and press up to a bridge. Walk your shoulders underneath you, lift your hips up nice and high. Feel free to press palms into the earth. Keep your feet parallel. Get this nice work in the thighs and the glutes.
lower back. Hang there for a few moments. Beautiful. Press through your heels, lift a little higher. That's it. Keep space between the chin and chest. So that might mean you need to lengthen your neck. Yep. And exhale, slowly lower from the top of the vertebrae, vertebra by vertebra. Roll it on down. Good, hug your knees. Rock left and right. Extend one leg down, hug one knee in. Let's stretch that leg up just for a last stretch here. Anchor the hip down, reaching behind the calf or the hamstring. Deep breath in, deep breath out. And then bend the knee, taking our lovely supine twist, opposite hand to the knee. Woo, twist over. Look opposite direction, letting the shoulder melt, the knee melt. Breathing in and breathing out. Releasing here, letting go of any tension in the wrists, in the jaw. Slowly come back through center. If you gotta go, I know it's past the time. I love you. If you can stay, stay. All right, bring your hips back underneath you. Hug your knee into your chest. Roll the ankle one way and then the other. And then extend that leg up from the knee. Anchor the hip down. So what I mean by that is the hip wants to lift up. Gotta anchor that baby down, gently pull behind the calf or the hamstring, not behind the knee. Kindness to the leg, no judgment of the leg. And then bend that knee, opposite hand to the knee, supine twist the other side. And look opposite direction, close the eyes. Enjoy this undoing of the doing. Deep breath in and deep breath out. Beautiful. Release. Come back to your spine. Yogi's choice if you want to take a happy baby or hug your knees into your chest or go straight to Shavasana. Pull the knees down. Release. And then on your own, meet me in a nice Shavasana. Take up space. Take a morning stretch. And then relax. We'll be here for a minute or two, allowing the body to soak up all the goodness. Deep breath in and deep breath out. Hanging there for a few moments. Deep breath in and deep breath out. Allowing the eyes to soften, the jaw, even the shoulders, just letting it go.
anything comes up for you, notice. I am safe. I am here. I am ready for today. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Slowly start to wiggle. Take your time. Rock the head left and right. And then in your creative way, meet me in a seated pose, taking your time. Yeah, taking your time. Good. And then when you're ready, find that nice tall seat. Just like in the beginning of our practice. Let's take one hand to the heart and one hand to the belly, noticing the heat of your hands. Or maybe they're cold, I don't know. Just noticing what you feel. Feeling grounded, rooted. That whatever happens today, whatever comes our way, we have our footing. We will not be shaken. Breath in and out. Hands together. Thank you for moving with me today. I'll see you again. Namaste.